I'm Grace, and here is my Adobe Draw tutorial. First, I start off with the background. When you're doing backgrounds, I recommend in Adobe Draw specifically using color coding. You'll see that with everything, not specifically backgrounds. But for backgrounds, just try your hardest because you can go in and fix it later. But just do it. I recommend doing it first because characters are going over top of it, and when you're not sure where characters are specifically going, you tend to get sloppy a little bit. So I recommend doing it first. I use the shape tool here. I use it twice and then erase it once. But yeah, so I use this type of texture for the grass because it adds dimension when you're doing 2D art without shadows, which is what I did with this. But yeah. Adobe Draw has this thing where you can see things even when they're on the sides. It really is annoying. Moving on to drawn characters, I recommend lowering the opacity because it's easier to see when you already have a background. Plus, it's simple and easy for doing more and more detail to a character before inking it, because this is the sketching process. I also, again, color coding, I use it a lot. But yeah, so as you can see, I have the circle, here, it'll show it better. So circle, line, and then an arch under the circle, define the face a little bit more, and then you draw a line and a triangle, and on the edges of the triangle closest to the head, you draw little circles, and that's where your shoulder is. That's probably the simplest way that I found to draw human-ish beings. But yeah, moving on, I try to draw hands. I'm not very good at drawing hands. I end up erasing all three of the hands that I attempted to draw because I just can't draw hands very well. So ignore this process. Yeah, I basically do the same thing with the Animal Crossing character. And if you're wondering, what am I basically doing here is I am taking my avatar in different video games and turning it into art or something. You'll see it in the side. I have Pokemon, I have Minecraft, and I have Animal Crossing, and I'll add Among Us in a minute. But that's basically just what I'm doing. As you can see here with hair, it's really, really good to just think if this character was positioned this way, where would it fall? That's one of the easiest ways to just get hair to look correct. So right now what I'm doing is I'm going in and adding clothes more defined. I'm just outlining everything because it looks better this way, and it's way easier to ink because the sketching process is a thicker tool and not as precise. Here I've thinned it down and I'm doing eyes now. Just having fun with it a little bit. This is just to define everything. Here you can see me trying to draw Ditto. I actually got it pretty good here. But yeah, so just adding things to the background, and yeah, that's really all that I did here. Here I'm logging out and saving the video. And whoa, here we are, day two. So what I'm doing here is this entire point of the video is pointless. Basically, this character, avatar, has glasses, but I ended up realizing, oh wait, I can't draw glasses very well. So they just get erased. So this makes no sense. But trying to draw objects onto characters is one of the hardest things to do. So when you're trying that, just don't expect it to be perfect because it's not. Here I'm going through this character, and for some reason I am using green. Even the background's green. I'm pretty sure that I ended up changing that. I hope I ended up changing that. But yeah, so going with that lines. Oh, I didn't change it. Okay. This character's outfit got changed, but yeah, as you can see, you'll see it again with the clothes here, because this character is sideways. you'll see everything is falling down towards the earth, towards the ground, towards the center of gravity, if you will. And I once again attempt to draw hands. If you don't have to draw hands, I don't recommend that you do unless you're good at it. And I'm not good at it. But basics to hands, when I can draw them, I just couldn't that day, is think of, look at your hand, and the lengths is going to be how long you want to try and draw them. And mine tend to be spikier because I used to have nails. I don't anymore. Well, I do have nails, but I used to have really long nails. So they tend to be spikier just because that's how I started drawing hands. As you can see here, I put them on a different layer to try and readjust them, even though it's erased. But yeah, that's really what you do here. And here I've started inking, just taking the black pen tool, going over everything. And yeah, you can see that tint there that ends up not being visible, but I still drew it because I did the background first. You can see me here already saying the outside. It doesn't affect the final image, but you know, drawing the house. You'll see this with my lines, especially when I'm inking. A lot of my lines tend to be really thick in some areas. That's part of my art style. You don't have to necessarily have that to have a good art style. I just do. So you'll see stuff like that. That's just my art style has it, but a lot of people's don't. You can see here, I'm just going through inking. I think probably the easiest way to ink is just go over the lines that you have, and if something doesn't look right, just attempt it on the ink layer a couple times and then just go back to the sketch and fix it. As you can see here, the glasses didn't make it. They didn't make it through the inking process. I decided that they didn't look right. The background, I had to erase behind it, which ends up really annoying me later, because I decided to combine the done sketch, the done ink, and the background, which wasn't a good idea, because then when I'm trying to erase the background of other characters, I'm getting this character mixed up. I wouldn't recommend doing that, is all I'm saying, but I did end up doing that. But as you can see here, it's inking. It's pen. It's just tracing over what I already have. Of course, when you're inking, the best thing to do is to think about if something doesn't look right in the version that you have, how are you going to make this right? So I'm going in and doing that. As you can see, the thick lines, they are back. You'll see that a lot. Mask lines are one of the hardest things to do. I've been drawing masks on characters since before COVID was a thing. So you'd expect me to be okay at it by now, but no, I still suck at it. Here I'm moving on to the Among Us character. And now this one is probably the easiest to draw, because I'm not changing anything. It's just what my Among Us character has on. But the lines for this character were very annoying. Here you'll see me going in with this character. For this character, my Animal Crossing character, I didn't ink the hands at the beginning because I was like, I don't wanna do that. But I ended up finding a solution, which is good, I guess. I have a solution. But if something like that happens and you don't know how to fix it, just try again. I think it's probably the best advice I've ever heard. Just, if this doesn't work, try this. If this doesn't work, try this. And, you know, like I said, it shows there, I wrote Plan C, because it's like, this type of hand didn't work, this type of hand didn't work. Well, guess we're just going to cover the hands up. But yeah, see how I'm going over an ink, but if that didn't work and it looked wrong, then I would go back to the sketch layer and fix it. Here I'm doing the eyes, which I think is probably one of the hardest things to draw besides hands. With eyes, I'll do it in a minute here. I'm just making lines thicker and erasing things that I needed to erase. But you'll see that I added it to a new layer and then drew the eyes, which is the best thing you can do, because then I drew a slightly opaque line, drew that, and then lined it up, lined the lines up, erased the lines, fixed a little. So here I'm just doing the erasing thing. I don't know all how much I missed, but the recording cut out, so I hope there isn't too much silence. But yeah, I've made the background seeable now. You have double clicking and double clicking again. I don't know what I wrote there. I can't decode my own handwriting. Now I've moved on to coloring. Essentially, if you hold down in Adobe Draw, it will fill in the color. There is a chance this will work. It stopped working for me for a little while towards the end. But here you can see me, I'm just going in with the colors on the color wheel. That's the easiest way I know how to make colors. It's the way Adobe Draw that tells you to make colors. But yeah, that's what I do for coloring, is just find the color you want, darken it, lighten it, mix it around. Here I end up figuring out how to do the sky, but I couldn't do it for a little while. So yeah, I'm just finishing that up and moving on to the other character. So one of the things with this is, as you see, if you look in the corner, the color layers aren't combined with the main inking layer. I recommend this because when you erase, it's easier. And when you go to fill something in, you don't have to worry about lines splitting up hair in the front and hair in the back, which is very, very nice to have. So now I'm going in with the sweater, finish that up. And now I'm moving on to hair. Brown and blonde are some of the hardest colors, I think, to get, because you don't want them to look unnatural and you don't want them to look like a character's skin tone. That happens a lot when I'm trying to make blonde characters, and it's like, oh, wait, that looks like the skin tone. Uh-oh. But the character in the middle has blonde hair, and I couldn't get it correct. So I just went with more brown hair. Mixing up characters' hair colors is something that I do all the time, because if it works, it works. Oh, adapt and overcome. You can see me here trying to mix up blondes, and it just is skin tones. Here I end up erasing the hand because I thought that looked wrong, and it did, and that part wasn't even supposed to be there. But I go in, I color it in, and then I go in with the inking pen again and fix it. Now I'm just coloring in hair. Color theory is, I think, one of the best things you can learn. Is this color is opposite from this color, and this color goes well with this color. It's just very, very helpful a lot of the time. I use pastels a lot instead of more vibrant colors, so you'll see things like that. Eyes, I don't normally just do plain eyes. I don't do that very often. But I did for this. Here I'm coloring in the grass, and you can see the stripes come into play here, where alternating stripes with dark green and light green, because you see that in real life, not as drastic as it is here. But if you look at things like baseball fields, if you Google stuff like baseball fields, then you'll see it, because that's just how they do it. But yeah, here I'm going in to the background and doing those colors. And honestly, it's coloring. Here I'm doing textures, just trial and error, try to make it the right texture. There it is, bricks, like that. I have stone underneath it, leaves for the tree, shingles for the roof. It's just, what do you want this to look like? It looks like that? Okay. But yeah, so I'm just clearing the edges now. And yeah, that's really all there is to it. Yeah, and there's the final image that I ended up with. So yeah, I would say it looks pretty good. That is all that I have, so thank you.